your number one news team covering the North. The Bahamas Tonight, Northern Edition.
Welcome back. Now to our week of love stories. In sickness and in health, that is the focus of this segment of The Vows. Tonight, we will feature a couple who has been challenged by health concerns in recent time. For the Clarks, it hasn't been easy, but for them, love has kept them together. Jamila Mizik reports.
In sickness and in health. They both have different versions of how it happened, but the one thing Valari and Vanessa Clark can agree on is that their love story began at a local Wendy's drive-thru.
Coming through the drive-thru, I saw these two ladies walking out with their food, and I really didn't get served and stuff like that, and I should have moved, but I was not moving. I was just watching them as they walk, right? And so apparently, I put the car on the side, right? And waiting for them to.
Not pull the car on the side. He held up the line.
They started talking over me. I was closer to him, so I thought he was interested in her. And they're talking, dark, and I just sat like this. And then he said, so what's your name? I said, my name is Vanessa. And so he's like, oh, my sister's name is Vanessa. So you know I wouldn't forget you. And then he gave me this look, and I was like, oh my God.
Vanessa is an award-winning gospel artist, but she says Valari never knew she could sing because he always sang for her. He recalls the first time he heard her sing.
And it was really impressive. And I say, man, you know, the tune, the pitch, you know, everything was in sync. You know, I say, man, this is good.
Remember the lady
the sitting
of
on
you?
The side of me, because I still, right, in awe of it. Everybody stand up and stuff beside me. Say, man, that's your wife. I say, yeah. And I, you know what I mean? And I had to get up too. You know, and man, I say, man, because again, it was good. And then, like I said, afterward, I started to see what, you know, she could do with this year, and not just
only
that
but he began to. He supported me a lot in my music ministry. Yeah.
Vanessa says it was truly her obedience to the voice of God which brought them together.
So the lady, she prophesied to me out of the blue one day. I was dropping a daughter home, and she just ran up to the car. She said, oh, said Lord, I have a word for you. And I said, excuse me? She said, stop pushing away the man who really loves you. And I break off running down the street, because that whole day I was with my friend. That's all I was talking about, like, what decisions should I make? Should I give Valari another chance, you know? Because like I said, we were off and on for years, and I was like, I don't know what to do, it was driving me crazy. And she's like, no, she say he's gonna be, say God package him for you.
And when it comes to their vows, Vanessa says the two have been through for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, and are now experiencing in sickness and in health. Vanessa was diagnosed with a neurological disorder, had a brain aneurysm, and a stroke, and now has a trach in her neck for a ventilator, which helps her to breathe.
And it's only by God's grace and some miracle that I'm still alive. I'm still in my right mind, you know. But he's been there with me through it all. You know, I was in a coma after I had that brain aneurysm, and was in ICU for about 2 months in Doctor's Hospital. But when I came home to, you know, he already had everything organized for me. I had a team of nurses, a caretaker to be here with me all the time. He had to do what he had to do to make sure that when I came home and I was comfortable with the new me.
For Valari, it was all about keeping his vows.
Love is not easy. It's something that you have to put your heart, effort into. You got to commit. And it can be something you got to want. In the realm of it all, you got to really want it. And like for me, you know, this journey we're on today, I know knowing my wife for half of my life, if the shoe was on her foot, she would have done the same for me. And that is what I always keep in back of my mind, because I remember the early days when we first started dating, the sacrifice she used to do to spirit when it comes to me, in light of what I was supposed to be dealing with and going through at a particular time, right? She did a lot, which I was surprised to expect. And so basically for me, I say, well, hey man, I got you all the way, you know, in the midst of all this. And like you say, you do have some little rough times, maybe you don't agree on some things, but you know, at the end of the day, we made a commitment to ourselves that what we want to do, and with our family and our love for each other, and that outweighs a lot.
Jamila Mizik, ZNS Network News.
Absolutely beautiful, one of my favorite couples. And that's going to do it for news. We take a check on sports with RJ Philippe.
Good evening, I'm Jay Philippe, and welcome to Sports. Buddy Hield had perhaps his best game of the season last night against the defending champions. But let's start this one off with swimming, where the Crypto Swim Championships are right around the corner, and athletes from Grand Bahama, guess what? They're gearing up.
The YMCA Wave Runners Swim Club traveled to New Providence this past weekend, where they took part in a Make a Swim meet. Coach Andy Lovett was impressed by his swimmers' overall performances.
We have 12 swimmers go down. At the moment, we have 11 swimmers that have got Carifta cuts in one or more events. It's now basically trying to get more cuts between now and trials to push themselves onto the team.
One of the top performers was Zoe Williamson, who competed in the 100 and 200 fly, the 100 and 200 free, and also the 50 meter free.
I think I did fairly well. I probably would have done better if I did my exercises more often. I kind of took a break off of that. But I did really well. I made 2 Carifta times and a CC Can time, which is excellent for me at this age.
Kamaya Sanders and Adea Smith combined took part in a total of 10 events.
Overall, I think I did good because I got 2 Carifta times in the 200 breaststroke and the 50 breaststroke, and I'm not that far away to getting the 100 breaststroke.
I took part in the 50 free, 50 fly, 100 fly, 100 free, and 200 fly. I thought I could have done better in the 50 fly, but I guess, yeah.
On the boys' side, Noah Knowles had quite an impressive showing for the Wave Runners.
Gonna be in the 50 free, the 100 free, the 200 free, and the 400 free, and overall, I think I did really good in all of them. I made Carifta qualifying times for the 100 meter free and the 400 meter free. On the 400 meter free, I think that might have been my best race for the weekend. But on the 100 meter free, I think I might need to do better.
Young Tristan Hebron and Asha Knowles sure did not disappoint.
I felt like I did good. Some races, I feel like I could have done better. But I still saw to my best performance.
I took part in the 50 fly, the 100 fly, and the 200 fly. My 50 fly was a bit slower than I expected. My 100 fly was quite fast. I'm still holding the top time at 101.03. And my 200 fly was quite good, but I think I need to do a bit more work on it.
Now the Carifta trials are slated for next month in New Providence. The Carifta Games itself will be held in Barbados April 16th through the 20th. Switching gears now in the association, Buddy Hield had his best game of the season last night for his new Indiana Pacers, posting a season-high 36 points, shooting 14 of 20 from the field. He also had 2 rebounds, 4 assists, and 1 steal in over 37 minutes during a 128-119 loss to the Milwaukee Bucks. Hield caught fire in the loss, including 8 triples. To put his performance in perspective, it was his highest point total since January of 2020.
And that's a quick check on sports. I'm Jay Philippe. Be blessed.